We're moving over to perovskite photovoltaics on by Toulouse on the reduced interfacial recombination in gold decorated zinc oxide nanowires. So
thank you, Maurice. Actually, just one name. My name is Toulouse because of him.
Okay.
Yeah. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Toulouse. I'm from Vrije Universiteit Amsterdam, the Netherlands. I would like to present our project with title Reduced Interfacial Recombination in Gold Decorated Zinc Oxide Nanowire for Perovskite Photovoltaic. Yeah, perovskite solar cell has seen unprecedented progress in efficiency, 3.8% 2009, and today is 22.7%. Everybody knows here. Perovskite has basic structure is APX3. A is cation, B usually is lead, and A is usually is halide. And the previous material is methyl ammonium lead triiodide or MAPI. However, there are issues of stability and device interface to affect efficiency and stability. To tune the performance, here we have two kind of strategy. To improve the stability, we play with element of A, B, and X. Here we mix of methyl ammonium, formamidium, and cesium. And then of cation, for anion, we mix of lead, iodide, and bromide. For another for the second strategy, that's to improve the contact and interface, we have two kind of architecture. That the first architecture is mesoporous architecture, and the second architecture is planar structure. Mesoporous architecture is large interface but non-ordered, and the planar structure is very ordered but less interface. Here, we study zinc oxide nanowire interface for purpose of that more ordered and large interface. Why zinc oxides? The previous perovskite MAPI is zinc oxide is not favorite to use, so everybody using the titanium dioxide. So here we use the zinc oxide for triple and double cation perovskite. Everybody knows here in this room that zinc oxide has high mobility and sustainable energy, and it's good for electron transport layer. And I will show later that initial stability problem with MAPI and zinc oxide is not problem anymore for mixed cation and mixed halides. Yeah. Because of interest with light matter and plasmonic veil, here we applied the gold nanoparticle to decorated zinc oxide nanowires. And this is the SEM image of gold nanoparticle decorated zinc oxide nanowire. It look nice, homogeneous picture. Yeah, the question, will gold improve the plasmonic veil or change the electrical characteristic? This is the complete structure of we have. The live picture is zinc oxide nanowire without gold, and the right picture is the zinc oxide nanowire with gold. And this is the structure as we use the structure of IVTO, zinc oxide layer, and then zinc oxide nanowire with infiltrates of perovskite, and then this is the perovskite layer, and then we use the Hall transport and electron transport spirometer and gold. And we compare two kind of perovskite, triple cation, double cation, and triple cation here. Yeah, we observed that perovskite completely inflates in the zinc oxide nanowires, and no bleaching was observed. This is the XRD of zinc oxide nanotube and perovskite. The blue one is triple cation and the red one is double cation. We observe that in double cation still content of the cubic PP light, PP2. And here is the photoluminescent of perovskite on glass, also photoluminescent of quenching perovskite. Interestingly, that's the quenching of PL here decreasing by addition of gold for both of perovskite, double and triple also. And this is the solar cell parameter. It's not bad. Yeah, if compared to the Planck structure, it's still lower, but this is, we get 11 and 12%. And we use the scan speed to measuring this value, 181, with step delay 50 milliseconds. And here, efficiency improved by gold nanoparticle. But the current density is not influenced by gold. It means that no plasmonic improvement here. Instead, that's Gold's particle increasing open circuit voltage and fill factor, possibly to defect precipitation. To understand that, we investigated the optical characterization. And here is the photoluminescence of the zinc oxide nanotubes. This peak is the band-to-band of recombination, and this is the type of the defect in zinc oxide nanotubes. Interestingly, that the PL of defect zinc oxide is decreasing by addition of gold here. So, and then we make a fitting of the PL defect here, according the type of defect that's in zinc oxide. We have the surface defect or oxygen vacancy defect and oxygen interstitial defect. And interesting here that's the oxygen vacancy defect decreased significantly by addition of gold, and oxygen interstitial defect also decreased, but is still lower if compared to the oxygen vacancy. So what mean that here the gold specified oxygen vacancy, so surface specification here. To confirm the optical characterization, we measure the electrical characterization by impedance spectra. That here is a Cole-Cole plot of devices, double and triple cation without gold and with gold. And interesting that the impedance increasing by addition of gold. And we make the model circuit, the circuit model. And here we have two element of circuit. One is an element of zinc oxide, and another one is perovskite. How to know? Here we use the parameter that this is not to change, and here there is some change. The interesting that the element of in zinc oxide, this is the element of parallel resistance here. So this is increasing the parallel resistance, but the element of modified capacitance here is decreasing by gold. And to elaborate that, and then we applied from Walter et al., which published in 1996, to visualize the densities of state in trapping, so using according this equation. So this is the represent of density of a trap of state, and this is the represent of the energy. And here, interesting that this is correlated with cello trap. Cello trap is correspondent with the electrode polarization, and the interesting here that this is the deep trap is decreasing by gold by addition of gold. The depth of thread is a representation of interface between perovskite and zinc oxide. And here we discuss about the band gap diagram of zinc oxide perovskite heterostructure, heterojunction, I mean. And this is a relative portion of conduction band and everything after tune, perovskite and zinc oxide. And a trap is represent of the trap distribution in double cation perovskite. And incidentally, that a trap is switch stable with energy level of gold here. So here we can explain why the emission of green is indicate that the emission of green emission as passivation defect, so decreasing here. Also, why the perovskite increase the performance. So I would like to close my presentation with conclusion. So here that zinc oxide as model interface to study charge recombination in perovskite solar cell. And zinc oxide, of course, have so many defects. However, gold nanoparticle passivated surface defect in zinc oxides. And but gold nanoparticle don't lead to plasmonic enhancement. Finally, efficiency improvement of perovskite solar cell by gold nanoparticle via open circuit voltage and fill factor. I would like to thank for my supervisor, Dr. Elisabeth Van Hoff, and our collaborator at the Vrije Universiteit Amsterdam. Also, I would like to thank to collaborator from Solayan, Dr. Julia Galakan. Thank you. And I thank also for my institution in Indonesia, Agency for Assessment and Application of Technology. Also, my sponsor, Minister of Research and Application, Minister Research and Education of Indonesia. Also, thank for Stable Nexo for supporting, and thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much.